हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन आवर चैनल ज्ञान विज्ञान ब्रह्म ज्ञान। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग हियर सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ सबकॉन्शियस माइंड पावर, हाउ टू यूज द हिडन पावर ऑफ योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड। दिस बुक इज ए Written by James Thompson. We will discuss here second part of this chapter. Your reality will ultimately match the subconscious image you have of yourself. Here's how it works. Earlier, I said that your subconscious mind controls your involuntary functions. That applies not only to things like your breathing and heart rate, but also to your actions and behavior. And it controls these actions and behaviors according to the subconscious belief you have about yourself. Let me give you a few examples. If you have a deep subconscious belief that you are stupid, your subconscious mind will cause you to do things that make you look stupid. If you have a subconscious belief that you are destined to be poor or that you don't deserve to be wealthy, your subconscious mind will cause you to mishandle money or to be drawn toward circumstances that keep you poor. Because that's where your comfort level. If you subconsciously believe that you are unlovable, your subconscious mind will cause you to push people away, to sabotage your relationship. If you subconsciously believe you are unhealthy, or that you will experience health problems, your subconscious mind will cause your immune system not to function properly and you will get sick. I could go on and on with examples, but I hope you are beginning to get the picture. The subconscious self-image you have of yourself determines your reality. So if you are not happy with your reality today, you need to change your subconscious self-image. Once you transform these deep-seated negative subconscious beliefs into positive ones, your reality will change accordingly. That is the hidden power of the subconscious mind, and that's what we are going to be addressing in this discussion. Like that, our old scriptures, Upanishads, says the greatest evolutions in our generation is the discovery that human being, by changing the inner attitude of their minds, can change the outer aspects of the lives. Transformed by the renewing of our mind, that we are to be transformed by the renewing of our mind. So this is not a new idea, this is a universal truth that has been around for thousands of years. The problem is we often don't do a good job of making this universal truth work for us. My goal is discussing about this topic to help you put this universal truth to work for you, so you can transform your life into the life you desire. And in the next topic, आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू हाउ टू डू इट. रिप्रोग्रामिंग योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड. बाय नाउ आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ राइडिंग योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड ऑफ नेगेटिव बिलीव्स एंड सेल्फ इमेज एंड रिप्लेसिंग देम विथ पॉजिटिव बिलीव्स एंड सेल्फ इमेज. बट हाउ डू यू डू दैट? देर आर एक्चुअली अ नंबर ऑफ मेथड्स फॉर रिप्रोग्रामिंग द सबकॉन्शियस माइंड, बट द अप्रोच आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विथ यू इन दिस डिस्कशन इज व्हाट आई बिलीव टू बी द सिंपलेस्ट एंड मोस्ट डायरेक्ट मेथड ऑफ रिप्रोग्रामिंग योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड. इन फैक्ट दिस प्रोसेस इज सो सिंपल यू मे बी टेम्पटेड टू थिंक इट वॉन्ट वर्क, बट आई कैन टेल यू फ्रॉम पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस दिस वर्क्स. एंड इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट दैट इट विल वर्क, आई हैव टू वर्ड्स ऑफ एडवाइस फॉर यू. Try it for 6 months and then compare your life at the end of that 6 month period to what your life is like right now. Once you do that, I am confident you will be a believer in the process. This approach involves developing a series of positive affirmation, utilizing your conscious mind, writing those affirmation down on paper, and then going through a deliberate process to embed those affirmation in your subconscious mind. As your new affirmation are accepted by your subconscious mind, they replace the old negative beliefs previously held by your subconscious mind. And as this happen, your reality will begin to change to match the new self-image held by the subconscious mind. Remember, your reality will ultimately match the subconscious image you have of yourself. Now let's take a look at the process. The first things you want to do is sit down with a pencil and pad of paper and start designing the life you want. The way you do that is by writing down a series of affirmations that describe you and your life exactly as you want it to be. You can include all aspects of your life, your finance, your health, your relationships, your charitable giving, your spirituality, the home you live in, the car you drive, your lifestyle, being a loving and giving person, how much you travel, where you travel, your career, and on and on. In other words, design your life exactly as you want it to be. How many affirmations should you write down? There's no magic number, but I am going to suggest that you start with about a dozen. I recommended this number because it's a large enough number to enable you to address several aspects of your life, but it's also a small enough number that you can pretty easily commit the affirmation to memory, which will prove helpful as you will see. I don't want to try to create your affirmation for you because they need to come from you, but sometimes people have trouble getting started with this process, so let me give you some example affirmation to get your creative juices flowing. Some example might be, I want a successful business, I travel extensively to wonderful destination, I live in my dream home, I want a beautiful houseboat, I am blessed with a wonderful family, I have a happy and successful marriage, I am a loving wife, husband, I am a loving mother, father, money flows naturally to me in abundance, I have more than enough money, I give generously to worthwhile charity, I am blessed with excellent health, my immune system keeps me in a state of constant wellness, I enjoy exercise. I easily maintain my perfect weight. I enjoy eating healthy food. I have an abundance of friends. I am kind, loving and compassionate. I am a delicate and loyal friend. I am filled with love and compassion for others. I am deeply loved by my family and friends. I bring happiness to others. Those are just some examples. The key is to design the life that you want and to create the person that you want to be. But even through affirmation listed above are just example. I want you to notice two important things about them. First, they are all in the present tense. Always write your affirmation in the present tense. As if you have already achieved them, the subconscious mind only lives in the present tense. So your affirmation must be far-fetched in the present tense. If your goal is to write a book, you might say, I am best-selling author, rather than I will write a book next year. Second, they are all positive negative words should not be included in your affirmation. Some psychologists believe that the subconscious mind doesn't see or hear negative words like not. So if you say, I am not afraid, your subconscious mind may hear that as I am afraid. So instead, say something positive like, I am confident and courageous. Don't worry if it takes some time to come up with your list. It's okay to spend several days writing and refining your list of affirmation. This process of coming up with your affirmation is a powerful process, and it's one right because it requires you to decide what you really want your life to look like. It's also okay to revise your list from time to time. In fact, that's probably a good sign that the process is working, because it means you are gaining greater clarity on exactly what you want in life. If you find that one of your affirmations no longer rings true for you simply remove it or revise it and add new ones whenever you want to. Now, once you have developed your list of affirmation, what do you do with it? This is where it gets really exciting, because now you begin the process of embedding these affirmations in your subconscious mind. And here's how you do it. Twice a day, simply relax, clear your mind and focus on the affirmation on your list. Visualize yourself as already having these traits and already having achieved these goals. See yourself in actions doing those activities and being that person. It's up to you to decide when you spend time with your list, but it's often been said that first thing in the morning and just before you go to sleep at night are two excellent times, because the subconscious seems to be particularly receptive to new suggestions during those times. Regardless of when you do it, it's important to put yourself in a very relaxed state when you review your affirmation, because relaxation opens the door to the subconscious mind. When you quiet your mind and relax, the thoughts and image you focus on sinks down into the subconscious mind. So here's what you want to do. Twice a day, find a comfortable quiet spot. It can be sitting down or laying down, whichever you prefer. It can even be in bed late at night and first thing in the morning. Until you have your affirmation memorized, it may make more sense to be sitting up, because you will be probably need to read your affirmation, and that's easier to do when sitting. But eventually you will commit your affirmation to memory and reading won't be necessary. Once you get in a comfortable position, take a few deep breaths, really focus on slow deep exhale. With each exhale, consciously Relax every muscles in your body. Allow your body to go a bit limp. After you take the last deep breath, spend a few seconds to really focus on relaxing the muscles in your body. Once you feel totally relaxed, simply being reciting your affirmations. You can say them out loud or you can simply say them silently in your mind. You can read them with your eyes open or you can close your eyes and recite them from memory. As you recite each affirmations, you also want to visualize each affirmation as being already true. Create a visual image in your mind of yourself as already having these traits and having achieved these goals. This visualization is critical to the success of the process. Your subconscious mind doesn't know real from imagined. It will accept as real the things you visualize. So let your imagination really run free as you visualize your affirmation. You should also elaborate on the wording of each affirmation and add as much detail as needed to really feel it. You want the affirmation to elicit an emotional response. It's not enough to say it. You want to feel it. The subconscious is the emotional part of your mind, so you must use emotion when programming your subconscious mind. For example, if your written affirmation is "I live in my dream home," feel free to add more detail as you recite it and say something like, "I live in my dream home overlooking the ocean. It brings me a great happiness to sit on my balcony and watch the waves crash in on the shore and to smell the ocean air." And as you say these words, create a mental picture. See yourself sitting on the balcony of your dreams home overlooking the ocean and watching the waves roll in and smelling the ocean air. Let's look at another example. Suppose you have a written affirmation that says, "I successfully run a marathon." You might add some detail as you recite it and say something like, "I feel exhilaration as I cross the finish line of the marathon. My friends and family are there cheering me on for this accomplishment." And as you are recite the words, visualize yourself crossing the finish line with your hands raised in the air and your friends and family standing there cheering for you. Feel the excitement and the sense of accomplishment. By adding the visualization detail and emotions to your affirmation, you supercharge your affirmation. This dramatically increases the speed and effectiveness with which the affirmations is embedded in your subconscious mind. After you have finished going through your affirmation, simply take a deep breath, open your eyes and go about your business. Or if it's bedtime, you can simply drift off to sleep after you complete your review of your affirmations. There is no set amount of time to spend each time you do this process. Sometimes you will do it very quickly in just a couple of minutes. And other times you will get deeply involved in the process and spend several minutes or maybe half an hour. It is up to you. Do what feels right to you each time. Get in the habit of doing this a couple of times a day. Make it a part of your daily routine, just like brushing your teeth and eating your meals. It just simply becomes something you do each day. This is important because of the principle of repetition. When programming the subconscious mind, it is necessary to repeat the conditioning often until the new belief is totally accepted by the subconscious mind. It is critical that you stick with the process until your affirmations are totally accepted by the subconscious mind. That's because the subconscious mind cannot hold two competing beliefs at the same time. फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड विल आइदर बिलीव दैट यू आर इंटेलिजेंट और दैट यू आर अन इंटेलिजेंट. इट विल नॉट एक्सेप्ट बोथ. सो इफ योर पास्ट प्रोग्रामिंग हैज इम्प्लांटेड दैट बिलीव दैट यू आर अन इंटेलिजेंट, दैट्स वॉट योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड विल बिलीव अंटिल यू ओवर राइडिंग दैट्स बिलीफ एंड इम्प्लांट योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड विद द बिलीव दैट यू आर इंटेलिजेंट. वंस द सब कॉन्शियस माइंड एक्सेप्ट द न्यू बिलीव, इट विल बिगेन एक्टिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द न्यू बिलीव. वंस यू स्टार्ट द प्रोसेस once you start the process of reprogramming your subconscious mind, some inexplicable change will begin to take place in your life. These changes sometimes occur quickly and dramatically, but often they occur slowly and gradually. In fact, sometimes they occur so naturally and gradually that you won't even notice them as they occur, but rest assured that the changes are occurring. Here are the kind of changes you can accept to see. You will gain more confidence. You will begin to believe that you are capable of accomplishing your goal. You will begin to see yourself as already begun the person you wish to become. You will begin to take the action step necessary to accomplish your goal. Keep a positive attitude even if results don't seem to be occurring as quickly as you want them to. Also, it's important to expect the change to occur in your life. Expectations is a self-fulfilling prophecy when you give command to your subconscious mind. When the subconscious mind expects something, it makes that things happen. As your subconscious mind accept these new beliefs, it's also important to take occasion conscious step toward your goal as well. As for instance, early I used the example that one of your affirmation might be I successful run a marathon. In this example, as you embed this affirmation in your subconscious mind, you would also want to consciously take the necessary step to prepare for a marathon. You would start researching marathon race in your area and decide which one you want to run in. You would put together a training plan and a timetable to move you toward this goal. In this way, your subconscious mind and conscious mind work together to move you toward your goal. So as you follow this process of embedding these new beliefs in your subconscious mind, continually ask yourself what step you can be taking on a conscious basis to move yourself in the direction of your goal. As you do this, you will find a renewed confidence that you can achieve and complete every single one of your affirmation. Commit to this process for 6 months and then take a look at the change that have occurred in your life. Once you do this, I think you will understand the power of this process. Thanks for listening and watching this video. Like, subscribe and share.